issues that need to be studied. Look here, we did a social study with 77 people with 89 questions over the internet, the first one fully internetly done. And we found that most people do use it more than 3 hours a day, 67%. And look, 94% never used it for online business. There is no credit cards in our environment. We can't get, there's no credit. The banks are not linked up yet. And if I, even if I want to try to use and pay something from Africa, most sites block us for even payment. So I have to send my credit card information, if I have one, to somebody in Europe and then pay, because Africa will be blocked. But most people don't find anything. So we have nice advertisements, but they are not suitable for our environment yet. Still lots of discoveries to be done. Very exciting stuff. And 71% use the internet frequently for learning. I mean, let's try it here. Well, here we are in a university, so it must be 100%. But there's a lot that we can learn when the resources are being limited. And we don't know where the world is heading to, but some of these resources are being limited in ways that we hardly know how to deal with it in this environment. And in our African environment, we have already done it from the start. And something very exciting, there's also innovation. Look at this. I will just show you what happened here. This is Beauty. She's in Macha, Zambia. Fired a satellite connection and a Skype or a Vimeo, Skype connection in this case. She's talking with Luke, who is in Arkansas in the States, and a teacher who is here, who is in Minnesota, in Minneapolis, and that's where she is. They're doing peer review of the performance on the piano from Beauty in Zambia. This is e-piano. This is fascinating stuff, and it's already going on for 2 years. E-learning in music. Have you heard it before? We're doing it already 2 years long now in rural Zambia with the States. And the second school in America in music education, McFall, is looking at this, making nationwide in America. If that's the case, which is going to take place, that's a real innovation done from Africa going to influence music education in the States. That's crucial stuff. Music is such an important part of our life where we express the inexpressible, and innovation is done with Africa. So is that relevant? Yes, because here are ladies from the villages staying in Macha for weeks on end to learn how to play music on the keyboard, which they might, for instance, use in the church or whatever later, or they might not have a keyboard, but they have a chance to discuss over the internet with a teacher from the States who has and do daily lessons. It's marvelous stuff. So it challenges the way we do pedagogical stuff, even in the West. It gives us new input. So this interaction using Africa as the case gives us new insight. Again, paper can be downloaded and looked at. All right. So there is progress going. How do we do that? We have an organization that we call Macha Works. Macha Works, that's how the community combines in a cooperative. And it works as follow. It works there to inspire the people so they reach their collective and individual potential, and does so through internet connectivity first, and local talent, and educate, and do whatever the community wants to do. With the right values. It's a value-based organization with optimism, friendship, embracing challenges, and passion for excellence. It's very important that we understand with which value system we are working. With competence to understand, to mobilize, to act, and persistence. And I tell you, these are important things in rural Africa where it is not certain if you make it through the day. you might have no electricity today, or anything might be broken that you thought that you needed that day, and you can't go to the shop. You have to persist.